mother, I'm mother of five children, and I'm now the grandmother of an almost one-year-old son, or grandson. So I know the meaning of stress and fatigue. Do we have anybody out there today that's stress leaves us with feelings of unrest, an overbusy mind, an awareness that something is wrong in our lives that sometimes we just can't quite put our finger on. Stress steals our peace and it robs our joy, and it robs us of precious time that should be focused on our families. So what is the antidote to this stress? I have found over the years that if I'm stressed, that means that I need rest. So we find in Matthew 11:28, it says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." I would like to read just a little devotional from you that I found yesterday morning, and it's titled, "A Cup of Rest." There is no quick fix, much like staying out of the chocolate chip cookies. Slowing down our life and our thoughts takes awareness and resolve. Old habits are hard to overcome. Change takes time, but success is attainable if we focus on what matters most. I have to admit, at times I run so fast that I have trouble hearing the sweet whispers that could help slow me down. And last time I checked, God wasn't communicating via BlackBerry. What a bummer. If that were the case, I'd be online with him all the time, if you know what I mean. Here's the scoop. Though I'd like to control and direct every aspect of my life, I fall short even on my best days. My attempts are anxiety-ridden and poorly executed. God has a much better plan for me and for all of us. My favorite Bible verse is Matthew 6:33. "But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and these things will be given to you as well." He says, put me first. Take time for me, and I'll take care of you. I've got you, your kids, your schedule, what's for dinner, the whole deal. Just take time for me and seek me first. God knows how crazy life is. He is patient. He loves us despite what we do or how we perform. He forgives our failures and misguided actions. He just wants our hearts. And she leaves us with this last quote. When we rest in Jesus, the craziness of this world will not mark us internally. Let's pray. Father, thank you this morning for bringing us all here safely. Father, thank you for each parent, each child. And Lord, simply because we're parents and because we're families, we face stress, we face fatigue, it's part of life. And we can't find rest unless it's in you. Show us, Lord, how we need to slow down, how we need to take time for you to put away our lists for a while and just sit quietly and enjoy you and enjoy our families. And Father, I would like to pray a special prayer this morning over the Silverdale Baptist family. Father, touch them in their grief, and Lord, help them to see and feel you in the midst of this trauma. Father, be with the rest of these families throughout the day, and all glory goes to you. Amen. Silverdale.